So far, the cases that we've considered are cases in which a page that we are faulting on is private to a process. So let's consider the case where a page is actively shared. That means there are two hosts, P and Q, and both of them are actively sharing a page X. And currently, some process on host Q is using that page X, so it is in the local part, in the working set portion of host Q. On host P, the process is page faulting on the same page X. So when it page faults, GMS says, oh, let me find out where it is. Well, it finds that X is in the local part of host Q. And because it is in the current working set of host Q, we want to leave it there. We don't want to yank it away from there. We want to leave it there. We want to make a copy of this page into the local part of host P so that the faulting process on host P will have access to the page X. Again, we have the same situation that the working set on host P is increasing. The local part has to allocate one more page in physical memory for the active working set for the processes on P. So the global part has to shrink by one. So this goes up by one, this goes down by one. Pick again some arbitrary page from the global part. It doesn't have to be the LRU page, because all that we're going to do is we're going to put this into the peer memory somewhere. So in that sense, what we're doing is we're going to say, well, take this Y and host it in some other peer cache. So who are we going to send it to? Well, we're going to send it to the host R that happens to have the globally oldest page. Remember that in this situation, the total memory pressure of the entire cluster is going up by one, not just this guy, because X is going to be still present in the working set of host Q, and X is also going to be present in the working set of host P, which means the total memory pressure in the entire cluster is going up by one. And if that is the case, then I have to necessarily pick a page from the entire cluster and throw it out onto the disk. And that's what we're doing here. What we're saying is that host R happens to have the globally oldest page. And this page that I'm replacing from host P in order to accommodate the missing page and bring it into my local cache on host P is to throw out Y over to host R. And host R, in order to make room for this guy in its global cache, has to necessarily pick a victim from its physical memory. And the victim it picks is going to be the LRU candidate. And that could come from the local part or from the global part. Again, if it comes from the global part, we know it's private. We can throw it away. If it comes from the local part, it could be that this is a dirty copy, in which case we have to write it out to the disk, or drop it on the floor if it is a clean copy, because the disk always has all the copies of the pages. In either case, the important message is that if the LRU candidate that we're going to throw out onto the disk, a drop on the floor, comes from the local part of R, that means, similar to the previous case, the working set on local R is shrinking. It's coming down by one, which means host R can do more community service in the future. And now X is present in the working set of both host Q and host P, which means actively some process on host P, some process on host Q are accessing this page X. I mentioned earlier that this is not something that GSM worries about. If coherence has to be maintained for the copies of the same page existing on multiple nodes, that's not in the domain of GSM, because GSM is simply a paging device. So it doesn't worry about coherence maintenance. That has to be something that the application or some higher level of the software has to worry about. So we can talk about the relative split between local and global in this particular case. Well, in this case, host P, local goes up by one, global goes down by one. In host Q, nothing changes because this is an actively shared page, which means we leave the copy here, just give a copy over to P. So the balance between local and global doesn't change. On the other hand, in host R, if the replacement candidate came out of the global part, then there is no change in the split between local and global on host R either. On the other hand, if the replacement candidate Q came from the local cache of host R. What that means is that the working set memory pressure on host R is decreasing, and therefore L will go down by 1 and G will go up by 1. I want you to think through all these four cases very carefully. The first three cases that we looked at were cases in which the pages were all private. And this is the only case where the page is potentially shared because it is in the local cache of host Q and in the local cache of host P as well. So now it is time for a quiz.